हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल एजुकेशन इन्फॉर्मेशन। टुडे हियर वी विल डिस्कस द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमी। द टोटल नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चंस इज 22। दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ योर एग्जामिनेशंस। हियर वन और टू क्वेश्चंस कम्स इन योर एग्जामिनेशन, सो बी केयरफुल व्हाइल वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो। एंड द पीडीएफ डिस्क्रिप्शन, इन डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स द पीडीएफ लिंक हैज बीन गिवन। यू कैन गो इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स एंड यू कैन डाउनलोड द पीडीएफ ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चंस। सो लेट स्टार्ट। There are 22 questions, the topic of world economy. So let's start without any delay. The first question is, as per World Bank, how many types of economy exist? So correct option is option C, there are four types of economics exist. There are numerous ways to classify economics and most common one is GDP per capita income. So here we will see there are four types of economy. The first one is low income economy, second one is lower middle income economy, and third one is upper middle income economy, and fourth one is higher income economy. So what is the range? The range of low income economy is $995 or less than $995. So second one is lower middle income economy. So what is the range? $996 to $3,895. Between these ranges, the income is called lower middle income economy. Third one is upper middle income economy. So what is the range? $3,896 to $12,055. And third one is high income economy. The range of this high income economy is $12,056 or more than $12,056. comes into the category of the high income frequency. So there are four types of economy. First one is low income economy, second one is low middle income economy, and third one is upper middle income economy, and fourth one is high income economy. So you should have remembered all these four types of economy and what is the range. These all are the range of this type of economy. So next question is, what is the India's rank as per GDP per capita in the world? So correct option is option C, 126. India's rank is 126 as per GDP per capita in the world. In the world, India's rank is 126, while in Asia rank is 31st. Population has helped India to attain high net GDP, but when it comes to GDP per capita, then numerous African countries also overtook India. Correct option is option C. Next question is, what is India's rank in terms of nominal GDP? What is India's rank in terms of nominal GDP? The correct option is option B, fifth. India's rank is fifth. So India's rank is fifth in terms of nominal GDP. So here we will see the rank. First rank is USA. What is the rank? $21.4 trillion. Second, Japan, $14.2 trillion. And third one is Japan, $15.2 trillion. Germany, $3.9 trillion. And India, $2.9 trillion. UK, $2.8 trillion. France, $2.7 trillion. Italy, $2 trillion. Brazil, $1.8 trillion. Canada, $1.7 trillion. So the India's rank is fourth. Next question is, what is full form of UNDP? What is the full form of UNDP? Correct option is option B. Full form of UNDP is United Nations Development Program. United Nations Development Program. UNDP brings Human Development Index report every year in December. Next question is, what is India's rank in human development? What is India's rank in Human Development Index Report 2020 as per UNDP report. So, correct option is option C, 131. So, India's rank in Human Development Index Report is 131. India's dropped 2 spots to 131 out of 189 nations on the Human Development Index HDI this year, according to the Human Development Report SDR by the United Nations Development Programme UNDP. The country ranked 129 out of 189 countries on the 2019 SDI, that is Human Development Report. Next question is, which basic dimension is not related with SDI? Which basic dimension is not related with SDI? So here the correct option is option C, entertainment options, because both all A, B and C options are comes under the three points of the SDI. First, what is the full form of SDI? The full form of SDI is the Human Development Index. The Human Development Index. What is SDI? SDI is an index that measures key dimensions of human development. So what are the three keys? The three keys dimensions are a long and healthy life measured by life expectancy. Second one is access to education measured by expected years of schooling of children at school and mean year of schooling of the adult population. So, and third one is, and a decent standard of living measured by gross national income per capita adjusted for price level of the country. So, these are the three keys of the SDI. Next question is, what percentage of world's poor live in India? What percentage of world's poor lived in India? Correct option is option D, 28. India alone has world 28% poor as per UNDP report of December 2019. Next question is, on which date United Nations release world's happiness report every year? Correct option is option B, March 20. Every year March 20 is celebrated as the World Happiness Day. UN surveys 156 countries of the world. It is celebrated every year on the 20th March to highlight the importance of happiness in the journal lives of people. The United Nations started to celebrate the International Day of Happiness in 2013, but a resolution for the same was passed in July 2012. So, next question is, which one is considered while making World's Happiness Report? Which one is considered while making World's Happiness Report? So, correct option is option D, all of above. GDP per capita, social support system, life expectancy. So both all three are the factors to consider while making World's Happiness Report. Actually, there are 6 factors that are considered while making this report. GDP per capita, social support system, life expectancy, freedom of citizen, generosity and corruption-free system as a 6 factors. Next question is, which country standard at number 1 in the World Happiness Report? In which country stands at number 1 in the World Happiness Report? So, correct option is option A, Finland. Worst performing countries are Zimbabwe, South Sudan and Afghanistan. Next question is, what is India's rank in World's Happiness Index? Correct option is option D, 144. In 2020, rank is 144th. In 2019, India's rank was 140th. What was period of first year plan? What was period of first year plan? So this is very important question. So first year plan was of 1951 to 1956. First 5 year plan was brought from 1951 to 1956. This was based on Harold Domar model. In the first year plan, agriculture was on focus. Achieved growth rate was 3.6%. Next question is, what was the period of second year plan? What was the period of second year plan? So the correct option is option B, 1956 to 1961. This period was the second year 5 year plan. Second plan was based on Mahal Nobis model. Industrial development was on focus. Socialist style of society was on hike. Durgapur, Bhilai, Rourkela iron steel power plants were established under the second 5 year plan. Next question is, what was the period of third year plan? Third year plan. What was the period of third 5 year plan? So correct option is option A, 1961 to 1966. This plan was based on Gadgil Yojana. China was become the biggest problem for this period. Bokaro steel plant came in existence. In this plan, both industrialization and agriculture were preferred together. Next question is, what was the main aim of fourth five year plan? Correct option is option A, financially self-dependence. This was also based on Gadgil Yojana. Highest agriculture growth rate was achieved at this time. Next question is, what was the main aim of fifth five year plan? What was the main aim? Correct option is option B, poverty eliminations. The 5th year plan laid stress on employment, poverty elevations, garibi hatao, and justice. This plan also focused on self-reliance in agricultural production and defense. In 1978, the newly elected Morarji Desai government rejected this plan. Next question is, what was the main aim of sixth five year plan? What was the main aim of sixth five year plan? Correct option is option A, employment generation. The 6th 5 year plan India was undertaking for the period between 1980 to 1985, with the main aim of attaining objectives like speedy industrialization, rise in the employment level, poverty reduction, and acquisition of technological self-reliance. Next question is, 7th 5 year plan was based on which model? 7th 5 year plan was based on which model? So correct option is Miller model. Social justice, employment opportunities, and development of indigenous technologies were on focus. According to the Miller model, firms will issue enough debt so that individuals up to and including the 35% bracket hold it. To introduce these investors to hold bonds, the competitive interest rate become 15.38%. No firm profits from issuing debt in equilibrium. So correct option is option C, Miller model. 7th year plan was based on the Miller model. Next question is, what was the main focus of 8th 5 year plan? 8th 5 year plan. Correct option is option A, human resource development, HRD. Literacy campaign was launched and focused on infra for industrialization. So the main focus of 8th 5 year plan was human resource development. Next question is, what was the main focus in 9th 5-year plan? What was the main focus in 9th 5-year plan? Correct option is option B, small scale industry, SCI. Worldwide recession was the main reason why this plan was not very successful. Next question is, what was the main focus of 10th 5-year plan? So correct option is option A, investment through FDI. Per capita income increment plan was launched. Huge investment came through FDI. Agricultural growth rate was of 4% on target. So the main focus of 10th 5-year plan was investment through FDI. Next question is, what was the main achievement of 11th 5-year plan? What was the main achievement of 11th 5-year plan? Correct option is option A, highest growth rate. Manmohan Singh was PM during this period when India clocked 10.08% growth rate in 2006 2007. Recently, government abolished 5-year plan system. So, the main achievement of 11th 5-year plan was the highest growth rate. So, this is the main thing of the 5-year plan. The main achievement of the 11th 5-year plan was the highest growth rate. So, these are the 22 important questions. So, I request all of you, please go in the description box and download this video for your study. So, thank you everyone to watch this video. Please like, subscribe and share the content with your family, friends and close ones. Thank you everyone.